conference is about what is happening in Wisconsin today around issues of diversity, equity, inclusion. What are we doing well? What deserves to be highlighted? What lessons have we learned? How are we using those lessons to improve the lives of all of us in Wisconsin?
So the Toward One Wisconsin Conference aims to bring folks together across different perspectives and different sectors to really think about our opportunities to build bridges for collective well-being.
The people that were part of this conference, I believe, were really coming from a constructive place where we're learning about what we can do.
Change is on the horizon because people are willing to arm themselves with education, with knowledge, and realize that, you know, differences are okay. We need to see people for who they are, not what they just look like.
The attendees, they come from business, they come from nonprofit, they come from government, they come from colleges and universities.
I think the conference will be beneficial to anybody who wants to learn more about diversity and inclusion, and for anybody who personally wants to get a little bit more comfortable with the topic, who wants to network with people who've already been down that road, find resources.
We need people at the top, and we need people who are at the very grassroots level, and we need people who are experiencing these issues to share their wisdom and expertise.
You'd be hard-pressed to not be able to find something that you would be interested in.
I specifically remember Hillary Ware, her session, just the insight that she brought.
She was very approachable, she had great experience. While she works for a huge company, the things she talked about were things that we can all do as individuals.
There were a lot of mixed feelings around Nicole Hannah-Jones, but one thing she helped me to see is that whether or not you agree with everything about the 1619 Project that she co-authored, she was an incredibly humble individual. She had some remarkable words for us, which I think transcended some of the political divisions.
It was just great to see those young authors and be able to hear them read excerpts from the first winter. It was inspirational. It reminds me and tells me that there's hope for our future.
We partnered with the UW Population Health Institute on Racism is a Public Health Crisis as a pre-conference event.
The field of public health has been working to amplify the connection between racism and health outcomes for a really long time. We're at a pretty important time in our state, in our country, and we've experienced a lot of conflict. If left unchecked, we'll continue to kill people, quite literally, as we're seeing in this pandemic.
Dasha Kelly Hamilton, she was just inspiring and empowering and enthusiastic.
Many of us are moving through the world with assumptions and movements that we don't even know how they got here. I describe it as all of us being dropped into season 3 of a Netflix binge. And we kind of know what happened in season 2. We don't really know what happened in season 1, but we do know in this season we don't talk to that neighbor. We don't hire anybody with that apostrophe in their name. We don't scout out vendors from that other side of town. We don't do that, not in season 3, and we don't even know why.
I think realistic and actionable outcomes would be take what you've learned and how do you apply that to the organizations, to the communities that we live in. We can't lose the momentum. It just comes down to doing what's right for people, doing what's right for the human race. That's what it comes down to.